Last time on Gaming Through the Ages, I played The Sims 2 from 2005 on the PlayStation 2, which had me playing as an ordinary human in an ordinary house. In order to keep my sim alive, I had to satisfy his needs such as hunger, bladder, and tiredness. Overall, there were some intelligent systems and animations here, such as how my sim walked differently when he got tired. The game graphics were fairly good, but overall the worlds were a little too small. I felt like I was trapped in an episode of the Twilight Zone when I couldn't cross the road or go into a neighbor's yard due to the invisible walls turning my home into a peaceful prison. Will future games continue to have such needy AI characters contained within tiny game worlds? Keep watching to find out. Welcome to Gaming Through the Ages, the series where we take a look at games from many different genres and consoles through time, from 1975 to now in chronological order. Once we've reached modern times, we start back at 1975 and explore a different group of games. Viewers of this series were given the opportunity to pick any game made in 2006 for the PlayStation 2, GameCube, or Xbox 360. The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess for the GameCube got the most votes. However, we won't be playing that version because this year the successor to the GameCube has been released, the Nintendo Wii, and The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess just happens to be one of its launch titles. Overall, this doesn't change too much since we won't actually have a Wii controller for all the motion movements, but since we are entering the 7th generation of video game consoles, it does mean we get to say hello to 16:9 aspect ratios. I kind of forgot to talk about the game here. When an evil darkness enshrouds Hyrule, a young farm boy named Link must awaken the hero and animal within. Will we manage to save Hyrule? Probably not, as these episodes are very short, but just keep watching to find out anyway. Okay, here we are playing our first Wii game. Now that object that you just saw on the screen, I don't actually have. I'm still using a PS4 controller. You can hear me, but you can't see me. Yep, my visuals are now obsolete thanks to the transition to 16:9 aspect ratios. I've got to say, the move to the 16:9 aspect ratio is looking fantastic. It just makes all these landscape views we see here just so much more spectacular and open. Okay, let's start. Press A and B. It's a bit of an advanced start. So that little blue circular thing you see on the screen here that I can move around, I'm actually pointing my Wii remote at the TV screen, and it's kind of picking up the direction I'm pointing it at. I don't really have a Wii remote, so this is all simulated, of course, but let's just start our adventure. So, new quest log 1. Okay, I'm gonna enter a name. Link is the default name, but let's put, Astral here. A-S-T. I don't know if I'm 100% used to this whole controlling the name input by pointing a remote at the screen. It's a bit odd. Okay, enter the horse name. We will make that Phaser. This kind of feels cool, but this whole aiming thing still feels a bit like a gimmick to me. The water looks pretty decent, actually, especially the bumpiness and how it comes up to the shore, but the waterfall section of this does look a little bit unrealistic. It looks flat, it doesn't look like it's spraying water much. I don't know, it just doesn't look like real life to me. Now, there doesn't appear to be much voice acting here, so I shall just read it. Tell me, do you ever feel a strange sadness as dusk falls? They say it's the only time when our world intersects with theirs. The only time we can feel the lingering regrets of spirits who have left our world. That is why loneliness always pervades the hour of twilight. Overall, just seeing his mouth move, but there was no words coming out, it kind of feels a bit odd. I feel this game could have been improved with voice acting, especially in this era now that we've entered the 7th generation of video game consoles. Voice acting really shouldn't be that hard to come by.
But enough talk of sadness. I have a favour to ask of you, Astral. I was supposed to deliver something to the royal family of Hyrule the day after tomorrow. Yes, it was a task set to me by the mayor, but would you go in my stead? You have never been to Hyrule, right? In the kingdom of Hyrule, there is a great castle, and around it is Castle Town, a community far bigger than our little village, and far bigger than Hyrule is the rest of the world the gods created. You should look upon it all with your own eyes. It's getting late. We should head back to the village. I will talk to the mayor about this matter.
Look at that, we've got a horse. I liked that tail animation of the horse. You could actually see its tail moving. And look at the shadows here of the people.
The shadows, I still remember the days when shadows were just little circles on the ground. And look at that, the sun, you can see like the sun flare lens, I don't know what you call it, that it did something there. It reflected on the camera in some way. See the horse's tail, how it kind of just flicks and it sways as the horse sways? These graphics are fairly impressive. Even the horse's little ears were twitching. And you can even hear their footsteps on the ground, the wind is blowing Link's hair. The trees look a little bit flat though, and the ground textures are quite blurry.
Hey!
Well, I got his voice wrong, didn't I? Hey, Astro, you there? I can't do that voice, I'm just gonna stay with the other voice. Hey, you mind helping me herd the goats? They ain't listening to me lately. Well, does my character just not talk? He just nods his head. I don't think I've seen Link talk yet. Hey, where's Phaser? Oh, crud, our horse is gone. So here we are into the gameplay, and by pointing my Wii remote, it's not really a Wii remote, at this screen, I'm able to move around this fairy. And of course, I can also run around, I can walk slowly. Let's speak to this guy. Come on now, hurry up and bring Phaser with you. Well, where is Phaser? Has he run off? Let's just explore somewhere and see where he may have gone. Now, I've got to admit, as we run along here, Link does look very different to how we originally looked back when we... Well, not originally, because the original Legend of Zelda game we played, it wasn't really the original, but it was one about 9 years ago. He looks quite different to this, but I guess now with the 7th generation, there's so much more details they can actually add to Link. Why is there no voice acting in this game? Why do I have to do this? Oh, hi, Astral. I washed Phaser for you. Are you going to say thank you or just stare at her and smile? Okay, I guess you will just stare at her and smile. Let's have a little look here at Link. You can see he's got earrings. You can see he's wearing these sandals with these weird, I don't even know what you'd call them, things sticking out of them. He's got like a pattern of three triangles tattooed on his hand. What look like little bandages around his arm. Sorry, I'm not very knowledgeable about the whole world of Hyrule and Link and everything like this. So I'm just trying to go by what I see here. And he's got like a green thing attached to his arm as part of a shirt. Then he's got like a white shirt underneath and a blue thing around his waist. This is very detailed. You can even see the folds in the pants and stuff like that. I'm pretty impressed overall with the graphics here. And even the plants on the ground, they're moving and they're interacting with me as I walk into these plants that stick out of the ground. They move around as well, so that's pretty interesting, and they also just sway in the wind. Now, as I splash here into the water, you can actually see little splash marks coming out of my feet, and walking slowly, you can see the water physics reacting to the way I'm walking, and you can see like a trail of interrupted water flowing behind me. So these graphics overall are pretty impressive, and 16:9, it's filling up the whole screen if you've got a widescreen TV, so this is pretty awesome. Okay, let's speak.
Phaser is a girl too, so you have to treat her nice like one. Oh, but listen, Astral, could you please do something for me? Can you use a piece of grass to play that song for me? You know, the one that Phaser likes?
Use a piece of grass to play a song? A piece of grass to play a song? Like a guitar. Is that what you mean? Get a guitar? Oh, this sounds ridiculous. Okay, let's pick this up. I'm gonna blow into a flower. Oh wow, that was cool. Okay, let's get on. Wow, look at this. We've already got a horse this early in the game, and I love the animations here, the way it walks slowly like this. Yet then it can go into a run. And then if I take my finger off, it has to actually slow down. It doesn't just instantly stop running. It's just quite realistic, well thought out of, and it even takes a little while to build up speed with the horse. Anyway, let's go back to that other character now. I forgot his name. Where has he gone? Is he this way? I'm so lost right now. He tells me to get my horse and now he's already gone somewhere. Oh, look at this village. Oh, there he is. Do we have a sword? He seems to have a sword, but we don't seem to have a sword. We just have a horse. I can't see any sword on Link, because you'd expect if he had a sword, it would be on him. Okay, where's he gone? Oh wait, here he is. Oh my goodness, my horse can even stand up and do that thing that horses do. That thing, I don't know what you call that.
where they do like a wheelie, but they don't have wheels. They do a footy? I don't know what you'd call it.
Ah, great timing, Astral. There was something I had forgotten to tell you. My son Colin is making a fishing rod so the two of you can play together. He should finish it today, so you can come get it at the house tomorrow.
Okay, so what do I do now then? Let's just explore. Is there any like wilderness areas or really open areas? I mean, the thing about this game I'm noticing is that we keep kind of going into these divided areas. Like it keeps having to, the world looks big, but then it kind of has to keep loading every time we go to a new area. It's not as open world and seamless as, for example, Grand Theft Auto San Andreas that we played.
Oh, I think this was the actual guy that we were talking to before. Oh, sorry to get you over here in such a hurry, Astral. These guys have been awfully skittish today. They won't listen to a word I say. Sorry to ask, bud, but how about you and Phaser herd him into the barn real quick? We ain't got much time, so you think you can do it for me?
What if I say no?
I'm betting that with you two helping out, it'll be done in no time. Just say the word, and you're ready to start. You're ready to start herding the goats?
So really, we don't have a choice. It just wants to give us a choice so that the game seems more open-ended, it seems.
I don't know. Much obliged there, bud. Okay then. You go on herding these little scamps into the barn for me.
0 out of 10. So do I just walk up to them? Yeah, you guys go into the barn. Keep going. A bit faster. Go, 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 go. Okay, that was pretty easy. Let's get the other ones in.
Go on.
Go, 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 go.
No, you ran off. You're sneaky. Come back here.
Where did he go? Okay, there he is. Let's both of you. Don't be sneaky. Ah, oh, that one snuck off again.
Okay, in you go. We're halfway done.
Why do they have to go back in the barn anyway? Can't they just kind of stay free roaming?
Wow, I got 3 in 1. That was pretty good.
Okay, last one now. Now, we're probably not going to see the whole of this game. It actually takes around 37 hours to complete. So what you're seeing now is more of like the intro of the tutorial, not the actual core gameplay and questing. But it's interesting to have a look at this anyway.
Astral, Phaser, much obliged to both of y'all. I can cover everything tomorrow without having to trouble you, so sit back and relax, bud. Oh, but how about today? You want to practice with the fences? Just wait a spell, bud. I'll get them fences up. Sorry that took so long. Okay then, y'all ride all you want. Y'all get tired of riding? Just jump the gate and head back to the village. Okay, bud?
Let's try and
go over. Yes!
Did it. Let me just practice that one more time. Ready? We're going over. Oh, my horse got exhausted. Okay. We'll jump the fence now. There we go. Do you want to save? Okay, I'll just point my Wii remote at yes. I'm guessing it's morning now and we have the day off from work at the goat place.
Hey, Astral, wake up! It's morning already!
Wow, this must be our house.
Now this, unlike our treehouse 9 years ago on the Nintendo 64, is actually really 3D. And look at that, you can even see the light rays coming in from outside. That is pretty cool. Jump down. Look at that, there's multiple layers to this. There's photos on the wall. This is so cool. We've even got our own little, I don't know if you'd call that a fireplace or not. It's got a little pot there. Maybe it's for heating up water or something if you want to take a bath. I don't know. I'm not really used to living in alternate worlds that are set mostly on the medieval times from what I can see. Anyway, let's get out of here. It even had a broom there. I love the amount of detail. Come down from our treehouse. Let's chat to these kids.
Oh, Astral, did you hear? They're selling a slingshot at the store right now! A slingshot! I wonder how powerful it is! I must try it! Teo, if you and Mayo want it so badly, just buy it at my parents' shop! Do you see any rubies in my head? I can't afford that thing! Come on, Beth, can't you just loan it to us for a while? You know I'd get in trouble for that. If you two want it, save up your allowances or something. But our allowances are terrible. Oh, I wish I was born into a family with a slingshot instead of one with a water wheel.
Maybe we should go buy a slingshot. That sounds like fun. Okay, let's go. Oh, wait a sec. See this grass here? This, well, I don't know if you call it grass. It's this long, tall, grassy-looking stuff. But when you walk through it, it actually
It's interacting with us. I like the fact that it's interacting with us. Saying, hey, hey buddy. No, it's not doing that. I mean, it's interacting with our movements. It's physics interact with our physics. I think that's pretty cool. And like this flowers on the ground, and these are individual flowers as you can see, and these flowers here, I even saw a leaf come loose as we ran through it really fast. That is so cool. But these individual flowers here, they're not just like we saw in the Nintendo 64 days, like a hexagon on the ground that sticks up. They're individual flowers that actually move as we move. Well, hey, morning, Astral. Got a day off from work today, my boy? Not me. The wife's been hassling me. Today's the day to restock our store. Look, see? Up that tree. If you use C and that and do all this stuff and move the cursor around, you can get a better view. Yeah, some Auridon bees built themselves a fine nest up there, and I was thinking about knocking it down. Our cat hasn't come home since yesterday, so the wife's been in a bad mood. At the very least, I need to bring her something home.
Oh, so he's the husband of the wife who owns a store. So where is this store? Is it over there? There's just so many...
Well, okay, there's not so many buildings, but there's just a lot of detail here, a lot of places, and it's kind of hard. This is Russell, Lully and Colin's house. I don't know if I pronounced that right. So I'm guessing that's not the store. Is this a store over here? One-stop shopping. I'm gonna guess that this is a store. Even this sign here, I don't know if you can see it, but if I lean against it and stuff, you can kind of see it leans too. So I think that's pretty cool. But once again, I don't like this. You walk into a house and it kind of has to load again. I thought maybe by the time we've reached the seventh generation, we might be able to have seamless walking, but so far, I haven't seen that. Oh, that's right. She does look pretty upset right now.
Oh my. It's young Astral. Welcome, my dear. You didn't happen to see my little cat out there, did you? He ate the fish we were going to have for supper last night and I gave him a good scolding, but then he went out and he hasn't returned. I'm so fraught and worried for him. I've exhausted myself.
Oh, I can see the slingshot over there. But she seems to not want it unless she has her cat back. So I guess we gotta try and find her cat. Where exactly am I gonna find this cat? That's like trying to find a needle in a haystack. I found a chicken. Stop running. Oh, okay. There we go. This is a good idea. Maybe I can bring this to her. Would you like a chicken instead? No, the chicken doesn't seem to like it. Maybe the cat told the chicken about how bad she was and now the chicken doesn't want to go in there. Yo, Astral! Try talking to me. Hey, there you go, over here. Yeah, your voice carries over well. Think you can teach my little twinks to talk to someone from a distance by pressing A while holding Z? So listen, why don't you climb up those vines there, Astral? Yo! There you are. Check this out. You know Sarah at the general store? Well, isn't that her cat over there? He's been sitting there next to my house having a staring contest with the crank. You don't suppose he's thinking he's gonna catch a fish, do you? Haha, a cat can't catch no fish. Anyway, that's not what I was meaning to tell you about. I want you to take a look at something. See that grass growing over there on the edge of the rock? Haven't I seen you whistling with that stuff? I figured it was pretty rare to see it growing up in a place like that, so I thought I'd just let you know. I bet you could hop across these rocks with just a quick little oop of the joystick.
I just don't know how to verbalize that movement, okay? With a little forward tap of the joystick, let's go. There we go, we got across. It's funny, this auto jumping thing. That was like the other Zelda game we played 9 years ago, and I'm still not used to it yet. But I do like the fact we've got this mini map on the side of the screen here, and it doesn't take up too much of our space because it's widescreen, so this is fantastic. Let's try and pick one of these flower things. Blow. Looks like some kind of a bird that we were blowing into rather than grass, a grass bird. Why does he do this though? Why does he blow into grass all the time? I mean, it sounds pretty cool. Oh, that was to summon a bird. Okay, that makes sense. The bird grass summons a bird. So we can set him free. What is that over there? There's something jumping up and down over there. Let me try and aim it at that. Let me try that again. I think I'm supposed to aim at that or something. Oops, I just opened the Wii menu. Wait, let me get out of this. Okay, let's try and aim it again. Oh, wait a sec. Could I aim it at this bee thing? Or were those things that he wants? Ah, yes, I can. Let's go talk to that guy now. Astral, I saw that.
Calling down a hawk? Why didn't I think of that? I was trying to knock that down myself, but you beat me to it, my boy.
Problem with me is I keep forgetting all the voices. There we go, we knocked it down.
Oh wait, we can climb up here.
Oh, this is a bit slow. Oh, crud. Is that like a... You found a blue rupee. Oh, okay. These are the, it's like the currency in this game, and that's worth like $5 or something. You got a yellow rupee. $10. Oh, crud! I'm fine! Oh, okay. So Link has some super strong ankles or something that doesn't have fall damage. Interesting. Who's this?
Oh, good morning to you. If you're looking for my husband, he took his sword and left early this morning, but... I must ask, Astral, you haven't seen a cradle come floating by here, have you? It's a baby's cradle made of finely woven tree bark. Oh, such a misfortune. How far could it have drifted, I wonder?
Wait, down the river here. Is that thing I saw really far down the river? Wait, let me go back up here. That thing down the river. I think that's the baby's cradle. Okay, let's try this. Wait a sec, maybe we have to just move closer and then jump further. Ah, crud, I fell. Oh, did you see that? As I was swimming, you actually saw bubbles coming out of Link's mouth. That's pretty cool. And I've come out of the water and he's actually dripping with water. Now that is cool. A lot of detail has gone into the physics, animation and graphics of this game, and it's 37 hours long. This is just insane. What have games become? Okay, here we go. Pick. Okay, there it is. There's the baby's cradle. Okay, point the Wii remote at the screen like this and go. Yes, we got it back. Why do we have to hold the baby's cradle like that? Looks like Super Dad here. I shall not let my baby get hurt by the world.
Oh, Astral, that cradle! Did you go to the trouble of finding it for me? My thanks to you! Oh, that reminds me! There's something I'm supposed to give you! Do you think you could carry that cradle and come back with me to my house?
Where is your house? Where are you? Oh, do you seriously have to walk that slow? I mean, I've got a really heavy cradle here and look how fast I can go and you're just... My walking speed's still faster than your walking speed.
My thanks to you, Astral. I suppose I'd nearly forgotten. I'm supposed to give you this, alright? Here you go.
His face. They always do this whenever he finds an item. It's his really funny face as he holds the item like that. You got a fishing rod. A simple fishing rod with a bobber. That's how you control it. You can fish with it with the hook, but you can catch a wider variety of fish if you use bait.
It's a little unpolished. My son Colin made this under the instruction of his father. You can use it if you like.
Okay, enough of this now. Let's go get that cat, because this cat might make that woman happy enough to sell us a slingshot. Think, is it this way? Yes, here's the cat. You're gonna... Actually, what did that guy say? He's trying to catch a fish, possibly. What if I catch a fish for him? How do I use that, fishing rod? So point at the item that you want to use and set it with B. Okay, so I've got the fishing rod, and I can set it. And then... Oh, cool. Here's my fishing rod. Oh, look at that, how it dangles. That is so cool. Okay, here we go. Throw. Can I catch a fish here? Crud, I've got control of the fishing rod in the water. This is so weird.
I can't catch this fish.
Okay, so I've been trying to catch a fish for a few minutes now. I'm not really much of a fisherman, so I think we might pretty much get ready to finish this up now. I'm sure I'm supposed to catch a fish for the cat, and then that'll make it all happy or something, I don't know, and then it'll follow me back to the house. I don't know what I'm supposed to do, but I think we might pretty much get ready to move on to the next game now. But I do really like the graphics of this game. I love that it's widescreen. The shadows are fantastic. You can walk through things and it looks absolutely amazing. Still though, there are very, very low textures on the ground when you compare it to real life, but overall this game seems pretty in-depth, great kind of puzzles that kind of link together to make you think, and overall some areas are pretty detailed. To tell you the truth, I haven't really been looking too much, but like, see this railing here? That is not a 2D sprite that always faces a player. That has depth, and I haven't found hidden 2D sprites thus far in this game. They may be hiding somewhere, but I haven't actually been able to see them. Actually, well, okay, maybe I take this back. I can't fully tell here, but these flowers potentially might be 2D sprites that always face the player. But you know what? They beat those hexagons that pop out of the ground. They look pretty realistic and they interact with you as you walk through them. Anyway, it's now time to move on to the next game. So where to next from here? The year in the next episode will be 2007, which introduced, well, nothing much. Unless you count the Wii, which is a Chinese copy of the Wii, but I don't, so let's move on. Anyway, for the next episode, pick a game made in 2007 for the PlayStation 2, Wii, or not the Xbox 360. I'll see you guys next time on Gaming Through the Ages.